my pre-workout. Food of today is gonna be an apple. Just half, not too much, just for some sugars. I love the taste of apples. So delicious, I'm ready. Let's rock this workout today. Hey everybody, it's Jake Mace with jakemace.com. This is our workout number 2 for our 2016 January 8 session workout series. If you guys want workout number 1, click on the screen right now, or the link is down below in the comments and the description. Follow me on Instagram at jakemacetaichi. Hit the like button right now before we get started. Subscribe to our channel. Give me a comment or a question down below. I love reading and responding to you guys. If you guys need the talk that sets up this video series of 8 workouts, go to workout number 1. Let's get to it. First, dynamic warm-up. Come on down on your hands. And hold that. The first 5 minutes of these workouts, guys, we're gonna do dynamic warm-up. Just to get the body active. Make sure you're breathing. Inhale. Exhale. Again. Again. Put that one hand to the middle. Open the feet. Go on the edge and get this hand up toward the sky. Hold it, lift the hip, and take 3 more deep breaths. Very nice, back to 2 hands. Again, I'd recommend getting a carpet or grass or a yoga mat, something like that. On the edge of the feet, open the feet up, one hand up toward the ceiling or toward the heavens, lift the hip. 3 breaths. A little bit of a smile. Embrace that dynamic warm-up. Back to both hands, hold there, and slowly go down to the forearms. Rest the arms, but now we're engaging our core, our stomach, a little bit of our thighs, legs, knees, hold it. About 15 more seconds. You guys can do it. Remember, no sagging backs, no pyramids, nice and flat. Keep that tightness in the belly. Now before you rest, climb up back to the palms and slowly walk the hands back toward the feet. Slowly, slowly. And once you're there, carefully stretch it down toward the ground and hold for 15 seconds. Let that blood flow go to the brain and the face. Oxygenate the blood. Very nice. Now like a sprout germinating and blooming out of the earth. We're gonna let our spine kind of stretch and bloom out that way. Back up to that standing position. All right, let's rotate the neck. Small circles this way. There's gonna be times during this 8 sessions that we're together where you guys aren't gonna wanna follow me and you aren't gonna wanna work out. Maybe you're full of spirit right now, but on the days where your chi or your emotional state is telling you don't work out, it's okay, just skip one. That's the devil talking, or whatever you want to say. That's the evil chi talking. That's the alter ego of the healthy, fit you, okay? Those are the days when you must follow me, you must do something. Anybody can work out when they're feeling good. Let's go arms forward, stiff elbows. Rotate the arms, small circles to the front. Of course, deep breaths. Going back. Now, elbow side to side. Bend those knees. Twist the core. Get that mobility in the waist, stomach, and lower back. Watch out for things around you. Don't hit anything. Arms side to side. Good, now sit on the ground, but not quite. Put our hands there, and we're gonna sit just like this with our butt off the ground, okay? Just right here and hold it for a second. I'll wait for you guys. Once you're there, I want you to get in a stable position, palms and feet, then lift your waistband or your belly button up as high as you can and get it up there toward the sky. Drop the shoulders, and let's hold this position for about 20 seconds. Deep breath. Very nice. Now we're gonna put the butt on the ground and balance again in the middle, which is easier if you have your yoga mat or your carpet or the grass. Just hold that position, like a pseudo boat position or boat pose or boat asana. Now from there, I want you guys to extend one leg out and grab this leg and pull it in toward your chest and just hold there for a sec. Keep that balance. And this is all part of the dynamic warm-up. Not necessarily that challenging, just kind of getting your body active. Kind of like when the lion or the dogs wake up and they stretch out. We're doing the same thing, human style. Other leg, I switched already. Now back in like this. Get the hands back behind you, flat of the foot. Push it up again. But this time, put one hand down that way and other hand out. And now push up. See, this is sagging. I want you guys to push up as high as you can and hold that thing like you're creating an arch in your body. Shoulders down, hold it, hold it. Deep breath. And slowly come back to both hands. Gather yourself, situate the other hand, and again, reach up toward the sky and lift the body up as high as you can get it. Activate those lower back muscles. Stretch that shoulder. Of course, you guys want to be safe and do everything at your own pace this month. Don't push it too far. You want to get right to the threshold and don't cross over and get hurt, but push yourself as hard as you safely can. Come back to both arms. Now hold with both arms, put one leg in the middle and extend this foot out, heel out, and then lift as high as you can. This is tough. Hold it. You got it. Lift higher. Don't sag. Ah, back to both feet. Okay, switch it. Other foot down. Thrust this heel out. Lift the waist up and hold. Deep breath. Two more. Lift higher. And down carefully. And return back to our balance position here. Grab the legs. Very nice. This is gonna kind of conclude our dynamic warm-up for today. Thrust that leg out, pull this one up again. Set two, hold it. Switch, grab this leg, pull it in. And we're gonna start today a little bit of blood flow through abdominal exercise. So bend those knees up right to here, like we did last time. Do a few crunches to get the body going. So overlap the hands and give me 30. 2, 3, 4, match me, let's go. 6, reach those fingertips. 8, 9, 10, 20 more. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep the feet down. 7, 8, 9, 20, 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, keep going. 9, 30. All right, put the legs flat out in front. Just like that. Reach for the toes and just hold for 10 seconds. Deep breath. All right, good. Carefully come on up on your feet. Now, we're gonna get that blood flowing a little bit, a little cardio. Today, we're gonna put the jumping jacks aside and bring those back for our next session. We're gonna do something different for cardio. We're gonna do knee ups in front, kind of like pseudo running in place. So hands kind of in front, like a fighter's position, just hands up, always guard the head. And we're gonna just bring the knees up right here. Simple, just like that, so copy me. Nothing too crazy. Sometimes it's not about being the best. Sometimes it's not about giving all you got. Sometimes it's just about showing up and doing something. Everybody else is doing nothing. Now, bring those knees up a little higher. Up there. Let's do 30 more. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20 more. Keep going. Knees up higher. Okay, now we're gonna use our arms for the last 15. Like we're running, let's get it going. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and now heel kicks back like you used to see the cheerleaders do in high school. Okay, heels back. I want you guys to get them toward your hamstrings. Keep it going, don't stop. Unless you have to. If you have to stop, it's okay. Push pause, come back to me when you're recovered. If you guys are better than me, you better be going harder and faster. Let's go for 20, faster. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And rest for a sec. Deep breath, 3 times. Let me hear it. Again. Back down for push-ups. On the knees is okay. Or regular style. The goal is full range of motion. And the hips right here, keep them square. Just 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hold. Hold it. Stomach, core, mental strength. 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Back up on the feet. Take those 3 breaths. Again. And have a seat back to the ground. We're gonna kind of engage the core again, but this time with toe touchers. So we're laying back, legs up toward the ceiling, straighten the knees, and you should be able to reach toward your toes, but not touch. And the goal is gonna be to touch with each sit-up. 1, 2, 3, 4, let's go. 10, keep going. We're going for 30. Last 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And up that way. Legs out in front. One more time, catch our breath while we touch the toes. And just hold there. 10 seconds, 3 breaths. Little smile. I was in the hospital before. When I was 18, I broke my arm really seriously. If ever I wear a t-shirt in these videos, look at my right arm. I got this huge scar behind my arm. My arm's kind of funky looking because I had to dissect my tricep, take it out, 2 surgeries, 16 screws, 2 plates. And 4 days in the hospital almost drove me insane. So I'm thankful to be able to feel this pain of movement because I would rather have pain of movement than bedridden in the hospital. I always think about that whenever I'm in pain working out. Back up on your feet. From here, set 2 of our knee ups, but this time, no leisurely knee ups. We're gonna go all out for 15. Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 more. Now, 15 heel kicks to the hamstrings. Ready? Get it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to push-up position. All right, we're only gonna do 10 this time, but make sure the quality is good. Remember Mr. Miyagi? Trust quality what you know, not quantity. Same thing for workout. Just 10. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, come on, 9, and 10, hold it. Now bring your legs like this, watch me. Bring them to a half split, like this, okay? Put one palm down into the middle, and the other hand, reach it up toward the sky and twist as far as you can, and just hold there, half split, one hand down, one hand up. Catch your breath. Now, slowly switch, other hand down, other hand up, twist, hold it, catch your breath. Again, one more set, twist and hold. Other hand down, switch again, last one. All right, you guys, we're gonna do three more exercises, three more major exercises, then a 5 minute stretch and cool down. And if you guys look, I'm already sweating. It's 75 degrees outside today. January the 2nd, I think, or January 3rd today. 75 degrees in Phoenix. Why don't you guys all live in here? We should be in Hawaii. Anyways, we're gonna go for burpees first. Okay, I know you guys don't like them, but they're very beneficial for you. Let's go for 10. Try to match me. Number one, we'll do slow. Palms, hold, push up, suck the knees back, big jump as high as you can. 9 more like that. Let's get a rhythm. I'll turn to the side. Is that 3? Maybe I did a bonus. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 more. 9, and 10. Rest for a second, because the second major exercise that we're gonna end with is tough as well. While we're there, arms at the side, small circles forward. Breathe, guys, catch your breath. If you're feeling a bit nauseous, that's the apple pie talking from Christmas dinner. No, push pause. Have a seat. Gather yourself. When you're ready, come on back. We're gonna focus on the legs here for the second of our final exercises. A little bit of a jump, all right? We gotta get a little bit athletic. So watch me do one. Drop down nice and low. Jump as high as you can. Bring the knees up and land softly. Down, knees, land soft. I need you guys to land like a martial artist, not like a football player. I want you guys to land like a ninja. No sound, very quiet, because the landing is tough. It uses muscles. And by landing soft, not only are we getting a better workout, we're also being good to our joints. Here we go, let's go for 10. 1, again. 2, again. 3, keep going. 4, get it. 5 more. 6, 7, as quiet as you can land. 8, go. 9, last one. 10. Whew. Did you guys just watch? Wish I could see you guys. Hope you stuck with me. All right, our final exercise here is gonna be called switches. I call them switches. Other people will call them different things. We're gonna start in a push-up like position. We're gonna do a push-up. Then we're gonna switch, like in wrestling or grappling or ground fighting. Kick one leg through, put this hand back behind, and get to a crab walk position. Lift the hips up, then go the other direction, other hand up, bring it back to push-up position. Did you guys follow that? Or is it too confusing? A lot of these exercises, probably 100% of them, are very applicable for a martial artist or a fighter. Because we do Kung Fu, Tai Chi, Qigong here at the Shaolin Center channel. But for the regular person who doesn't want to fight, the practice of fighting is one of the best things for fitness, I think. Ready for 10 of these? Let's go. 10 switches. Just stick with me. We'll go nice and slow for the first day here. 1. Left hand up. Switch through. Arch up. Right hand up. Go back. 2. Left hand up, switch through, arch. Right hand up, bring it back. 3. Keep going. Switch, arch, bring it back. 4. Left hand up, arch. Right hand up. 5. That's halfway. Keep going. Switch. Right hand. 6. Keep going. Stretch. Bring it back. 7. 3 more. Arch it up. This is awesome. 8. Arch. Bring it back. 9. Last one after this. Arch. Final rep. 10. Sit through. Arch up. Bring it back. Hold. 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 And up on your feet. All right. Give me 5 deep breaths, putting your hands right here on your stomach. If this is my upper stomach, this is my middle stomach, and that's where I want you guys to put your hands, right here, in your nose, out the mouth. Again. Do it again. Breathing with our stomach. 2 more. Last one, hold the inhale in. Exhale. All right, have a seat on the ground. We're gonna put one leg out in front, left leg straight, right leg bent over the top of the left. Thread the needle so the right knee is bent. And if my right knee is bent, I turn to the right. Put the elbow there. For those of you who are really flexible, grab onto the bottom leg. Then sit tall and twist and look away and hold. And try to breathe calmly. And by calmly, I mean deep inhale, as deep as your twisted, contorted position will let you go. And then a slow, controlled exhale. One more like that. Relax it and slowly come back to center. And while we're at the center position, let's really get into the stretch this time. Okay, grab onto the toes, and touching the toes is stage 1. Then stage 2 is reaching over your toes and putting the butt of your palm into the crease of your toes right there. That's stage 2. So stage 1 is touching. Stage 2 is over the top. And stage 3 is with a straight neck and a flat back, as flat as you can go. We're gonna bring the elbows down to the shins. 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relax. Whatever stage you did is perfect. We'll grow from there. Other leg on top, left knee bent, turn to the left. If you can do it, grab onto the bottom leg, straighten the back, posture, sitting tall, and turn, hold it. One more breath. And relax. Now, let's work on some hip and leg flexibility. It's also good for the core and the back. I've been teaching full-time now, guys, for about 15 years. It's been about 15 years I've been teaching my full-time gig. And over that time, I've taught thousands of people, maybe even 10,000 plus people. I've taught a lot of people. And I have seen humanity evolve over that 15-year period. And the 3 parts of the human biology that are getting worse with each year, that modern society is making worse, the 3 parts are lower backs are getting worse, they're getting more painful and less flexible and less able, less athletic. Number 2 is hamstrings. People throw out hamstrings left and right because they never use them. You don't use your hamstring when you're sitting down at a desk. And number 3 is the wrist. People in my class sometimes when they first start with me can barely even do 1 push-up because their wrist won't let them. It's amazing. So doing things like this, hopefully you're already here, is gonna keep us supple, youthful, and caveman-like or cavewoman-like, keeping us strong as our ancients were. Grab onto this foot. Chest out. Stretch toward the leg. Hold it. Try to take your other arm and come over the top. Elongate your torso and hold there. 10 seconds. Deep breath in. Slow breath out. 1 more. Other direction. Grab this foot. chest out, sitting tall, stretch toward the leg, other arm over the top, hold it, two breaths. And then from there, either touch the ground, that's stage one. Stage two is gonna be put your forearms on the ground. It's a little harder. And stage three is gonna be trying to lay your chest, torso, or belly button on the ground. So whatever stage you got, go to there and hold for 10 seconds. Slowly come on back and either slowly, very slowly, take your time, take a deep breath, put your legs together, or if you can, rock forward onto the feet, climb it forward, and bring those feet up to a standing position. If you can do that, Jean-Claude Van Damme will be proud of you guys. All right. Not a lot of martial arts in this workout today, that's okay. Martial arts appropriate activity is what we did. So that'll set us up for success for the rest of the month. This is day two. This is Monday's workout. If you want to see day one, which we started on Thursday of last week, you can click on the link right here, or again, go to it in the description and the comments below. Follow me on Instagram at Jake Mace Tai Chi. I'm at Facebook, facebook.com/jakemace.taichi. You can join my online school and find out more about me at jakemace.com. You can join my gardening and vegan athlete YouTube channel at youtube.com/veganathlete. And also please hit the like button, add this video to your favorite so that all your friends can see what you're doing for your workout and share this video with your friends, share it on Facebook. Two rules before we end this video today. Number one, within 30 minutes of stopping this lesson today, get a nutrient-dense, healthy meal into your body, whatever that means to you. I'm not gonna do too much nutrition education during this series, just workout. So you guys have to figure out what is nutrient-dense and healthy to you. I guarantee you it's gotta have fruits and vegetables in it. Go do that within 30 minutes because you need to replenish what we worked out today. Number two, if this was not enough workout for you today, go back and the things you liked, do more reps of them. And for those of you who are trying to target one area of your body, like the flabby part of your arms, or your endurance, or your stomach, or your legs, or your flexibility, you need to right now, before you stop for the day, pick one of the activities that we did that targets that area you're trying to develop, and do one extra set right now. Thanks for joining me, guys. I love having you guys train with me. I'll see you guys next time for workout number three here at the Shaolin Center YouTube channel.